We've got a great winner's bracket match here between two of the premier blockers in America, Brad Keenan and Matt Furbringer at 6'8", as well as two of the up-and-coming Olympic hopefuls for Rio in 2016 playing defense behind them.
Go, we take a look at the competition format. It's a $150,000 prize purse. Rally scoring the best of three sets. If we get to a third game, we play to 15, and again, you score on every point. And Matt Furbringer
comes out with an easy one,
tapping it down for the point. Here is Nick Lucena going after Keenan. The set to Keenan in the middle. Keenan's shot around the block lands in for the point.
This will be interesting to see. The last match both these teams played, the big guy was served. Typically, we serve the smaller player out here in the deep sand, but I think Brad Keenan's going to see some balls today.
And Johnny Mayer's serve finds the outside of the net. Both Johnny Mayer and Brad Keenan very aggressive on the serving end.
Yeah, Brad's got one of the best jump serves in the world. When he feels like he's corking it, he will really let it go.
And here's Furbringer, went to Stanford University. Again, 7 career wins. With the jumper going after Keenan. Keenan up, and Keenan hits it just out.
Yeah, looking for the line, but he over-rotated, right, turned his shoulders, and just missed the sideline.
3-1 on the board, Furbringer back to serve.
Taking a look at Matt Furbringer. Again, stepping back to serve. And again, working on Brad Keenan. Set in the middle. And Furby blocked out of bounds.
Yeah, a lot of teams have a strategy of trying to make Brad do the passing. John Mayer is one of the best ball handlers in the world. So they're seeing if they can get some easy passing breakdown out of Brad Keenan.
There's a serve going after Lucena. Nick with a chance to score. Doug by Mayer, out of reach.
I think we're probably going to see a lot of tough serving out here today. It's probably more jump serving than normal. Huntington Beach known for having a fairly brisk side wind coming off the ocean, but almost dead calm out here today.
Going after Johnny Mayer, the lefty, and he cranks it cross court. And we'll switch sides. 3-4 is our score. Both teams mixing it up and going after the opposite players on either side. And looking at Johnny Mayer with jumper, going after Furbringer. Set out the Furbringer. Furbringer scores down the line. Big swing around the block.
Yeah, that's just too easy for Matt Furbringer there. Got an easy serve right in his lap. Perfect set from Nick Lucena, and it's hammer time out here. Not the deepest sand in the world in Huntington Beach. Not quite like Manhattan or Hermosa where we've been. More like Chicago or Fort Lauderdale, where it's only a few inches deep out there sometimes.
Furbringer again stepping back to serve. Goes again after Brad Keenan. Mayer set in the middle. And Keenan scoring down the line around the block. Notice Johnny Mayer keeps setting Brad more to the inside part of the court. What's the reasoning for that, Jeff?
Well, that was basically a mirror image of the last side out by Furbringer. They're just trying to bring it inside so they can turn it back across the line. Puts a lot of pressure on the line digger.
Going after Nick Lucena. Lucena rips dug by Mayer. Mayer with a chance to score, and he does off the block.
Nice aggressive set by Brad Keenan, probably 25 feet off the net. Put John right up in the window he was looking for.
High ball service, Brad Keenan.
Taking a look at Brad Keenan teeing off down the middle. Goes after Lucena, nice pass. The set by Furbringer, handed well. Lucena scores cross court.
A lot of aggressive offense out here and aggressive serving, which I love to see. So far, Brad's really getting after it.
Is it safe to say, Jeff, that some of the top teams in the world, or the top teams in the world, are some of the most aggressive servers?
Yeah, you know, you got to pick your style. Some teams want to keep you in system and let the other team have a perfect set so you can set up your defense around that. And other people say, hey, why don't we just go for the easy, quick point and bomb some aces?
Nick Lucena going for the jump. 2 jump floaties in a row, back-to-back aces as we speak.
And there you go. That's not really Nick's forte to can his serve. So he's gone floaters and still come up with great placement for the two clean aces.
Now, Nick Lucena, of course, a Florida State University graduate, a Florida State, love to say, junkie. And he said to us right before the match, dude, hurry the intros up, hurry the intros up. The game's on, I gotta go. He is ready for the Florida State Clemson game today and fired up about it.
He's a diehard Florida State fan and a Miami Heat fan, which doesn't always go over well here.
That's right. On the side switch, take a look at the score. Keenan will step back to serve 6-8. And Keenan going right down the middle. And Mayer going right down the middle, sorry. Johnny Mayer with an ace serve.
This is kind of what I was talking about earlier. You're going to have very aggressive serving and probably some clean aces without this win. Guys will be able to get on top of the ball and hit it hard and quick.
Goes after Furbringer. The set out to Furby. Furby. Nice controlled shot over the block down the line.
That's a great line shot.
Shot by Furbringer lands in for the point 9-7. And Matt Furbringer will step back to serve.
Furby's going to put away the jump serve. Let me go ahead and just put them a little more in system.
Nice high deep serve to Brad. Brad's gut shot falling just short.
That's what that deep serve will do. You can notice Brad's in here real early. He's already jumped, and he's on his way down when he's trying to make that shot. That Matt serve is just trying to take Brad out of rhythm. Jump serve, jump serve, jump serve, and then you slow it way down. Send it high. It takes that hitter out of rhythm.
This time he goes to him a little short. Keenan off the hands of Furbringer. Nice high hard swing by Brad Keenan.
Matt Furbringer way over the net with his block there, but Brad Keenan can match him inch for inch all the way up to 6'8". He can swing off the top. See if Keenan goes for it again. Absolutely.
Big rip down the middle, handled nicely by Lucena. And Lucena slicing and dicing. A nice cut shot around the block. Scores points. 11-8.
Cuddy Sark.
Nick Lucena with four career wins. A couple of World Tour medals as he steps back to serve.
His first was in Austin, Texas, 2005, with Phil Dahlhauser.
Phil Dahlhauser. Coming off the Pro Beach East Tour, which I used to announce. Both boys from Florida. There's a big rip down the middle. Johnny Mayer.
Yeah, both the blockers in their side-out game right now are trying to challenge everybody up top and high. Nick and John are taking everything down low and squeaking it in between everybody.
Oh, that's an outstanding set by Nick Lucena, and Furbringer rips it off the block.
Thanks, Tina. Yeah, Hayden Scott in the loser's bracket early. That's pretty rare for them. They've won three times in the Jose Cuervo Tour this summer, so they got their backs against the wall in this double elimination format.
Absolutely. Really, you know, obviously Sean Scott got hurt during one of the events this year and missed it, and Hayden struggled playing with Everett Matthews. You know, tough situation for Matthews to come in replacing a great blocker and a great player such as Sean Scott. But and then again, struggling with their tournament, the first one they came back together as a team, took a loss to Avery Drost and Ty Trambley early in that tournament. And
that was the upset weekend.
Absolutely, absolute upset weekend. And today, losing to Casey Boom Patterson and the Avatar. Everybody's talking about the Avatar. 7'1". How tall is the Avatar? Is it 7'1"?
He is 7'1". He's a legitimate 7'1", with some long arms, too.
Absolutely. And those guys really heating up, playing well today, defeating Hyde and Scott, defeating Rosenthal and Gibb. So an outstanding tournament for them, and we'll see them in the Final Four tomorrow. And there's a dig by Johnny Mayer and the up by Keenan out of reach.
If that looked like a crazy move by Brad Keenan, I'm guessing he definitely had to go over. He must have micro-touched that swing up of the net, so he had to send his third contact over there.
Here is Nick Lucena. 13-10 is our score. And Lucena, the deep jump floaty over to Brad Keenan. Keenan in the middle. And Keenan, the nice little shot away from the defender.
There's that cut shot that he was trying earlier, but obviously there, he was
Brad
on time.
The
hitter can come in and accelerate. He can usually see the court a little bit better, keeps everything in front of him. Nice little cut shot. You mentioned earlier they're looking for their first win as a team. Yeah, Brad Keenan is 0-9 in finals.
Including a huge comeback from Dahlhauser Rogers. Santa Barbara?
Santa Barbara.
It's in game three, playing with Johnny Hayden, and up, I don't remember what was it, 14-9?
14-9, I believe, going to 15.
14-9, going to 15. And one of the greatest comebacks I think we've ever seen in game three. Here's a push out to Furbringer. Furby ripping it off the block, and Matt Furbringer, just solid play here in game one.
Furbringer, sky high, ripping it off the block for points.
Yeah, Keenan Mayer have been playing well all season long. Really solid team. Buddies, roommates, partners in college up at Pepperdine University, coached by Marv Dunphy. They stick around, they stick around. They've just got to find a way to close out the big points and the big matches.
Here's a set out and the shot picked up by Furbringer. Here's the set, Furby with a chance to score, and he does cross court.
That's about as dynamic and athletic as you're going to see Matt Furbringer. Playing that ball on the run over his head and getting up and taking a full swing for a point.
Nice, there we go.
Matt Furbringer, nice up ball, a shot cross court, 15-12.
We can see the call here from Nick Lucena asking Matt to block angle, which he's done a lot here on Brad Keenan out of the middle. That's the danger with blocking angle. If Brad sees a move angle, then there's a ton of court over there. Maybe two-thirds of the court are exposed, and all he has to do is go over the top of the block.
And a nice deep shot by Brad Keenan catching the line. 13-15, and Brad Keenan will step back to serve, and he's set to launch down the middle. Ripping it right to Nick Lucena, handles it well. The set by Furbringer, Lucena up, and Lucena taps it off the tape.
That's just kind of a tough break for Keenan Mayer. Great hand set there by Matt Furbringer, brings it all the way up. Not quite sure why Brad Keenan dropped off the net. Probably might have had a stuff block if he'd have stayed up there.
And again, working on Johnny Mayer, the lefty up, and he's blocked by Furbringer.
Back to back, poor decisions or poor execution by Brad Keenan. He dropped off the net on a tight set, and there he set that way too tight for John Mayer. Furbringer can get his elbows, both elbows well over the net and grab the ball, and that there's just no chance for Mayer there.
And here's Johnny Mayer. Cuddy finds the net. And we'll have a timeout.
Look like the same
here
thing
on stadium court.
Take a look here at the replay. We can see that sets a little bit too tight for John Mayer. Matt Furbringer, both elbows over the net, getting an easy point. Well, we'll get back to that in just one second. We're taking a nice look at here at the 2012 champions on the Jose Cuervo Beach Volleyball Series. Hayden and Scott winning three events, Fort Lauderdale, Hermosa, and Manhattan. Doherty winning the other two that we've had, Belmar and Chicago. Both those teams really, really hot this summer, very consistent. And you can see Jenny Kropp and Whitney Pavlik. You don't get more consistent than winning all five events. Absolutely dominant all season long. Playing off some of the success they started last summer, 2011, on the same series. And really coming into their own this season.
And again, what are the keys, as we talked about before, for Keenan and Mayer to really bounce back in this match so far? Obviously, losing control here down 13-18.
Well, there's certainly some don'ts, and one of them is you can't set the ball too tight. They just gave up two easy points by setting the ball right on top of the net, caused a hitting error and a stuff block by Furby. So they can't set it too tight. They got to make Nick do some work in the backcourt, shoot it over Matt a little bit more and move it around. And they've just got to try and get a break with one of these tough serves from Brad. He's
you piece of crap.
Strangest player in the world. Keenan got caught totally off balance.
But take a look at Nick Lucena, the Greyhound.
All the way to his left. One hands it over the net. Nick comes from the service line and dives into the 4-foot line, puts up Matt on the second contact, buries it.
Oh, Johnny Mayer just rips it down the line.
Now that could be one of the keys for Marion Keenan as well. If they can serve John Mayer and he can move the set around and make Matt have to move, he's not going to get over the net as far. So they could try some movement offense, move the set around inside and outside.
Again, he's serving that ball just out, and that's game number one, 21-14.
They're going to have to come out just like they did in the start of the first game, serving it tough at either player. And Brad's probably got to do a little bit tougher job up at the net. He's got to penetrate. He's got to create some tougher angles for Matt and Nick, for Mayer to be able to slide in behind him and pick up these digs.
And here is Mayer going after Lucina. Pushed out to Lucina. Lucina ripping dug by Mayer. Battle at the net. And it tricks back over and going to Mayer. Mayer scores off the hands of Nick Lucina.
Now that's a great start for Keenan Mayer. They served the ball right down the middle, made him fight over it early. Took away some vision on Nick on a tight set. Brad doing a great job of just keeping this ball in play, rebalancing, setting the ball to John for a perfect swing in the first point of the game. Really nice patience and ball control by them.
Here's a set by Furby out to Lucina, and Lucina scores. Dug again, and the tap down picked up by Lucina, and Brad Keenan again there to tap it down.
Yeah, I think Brad is getting over the net more. He's definitely creating a difficult angle for Nick Lucina, funneling both of those swings right into John Mayer's lap. Mayer should be looking to give another trouble ball to Nick. He's serving him a little deep, flat floater right now. Changes it up, goes short.
Set out to Lucina. Lucina's nice high shot, just out of reach. Mayer was tracking, but a nice, crisp shot down the line by Nick Lucina.
Yeah, I don't really like that choice to suddenly serve him short. They got two great plays in a row, serving him flat and deep and bringing him off the net. And they change it up. Nick back to serve. Again, not much wind out here at all today. Pretty still. Goes with a floater to Brad Keenan. Takes him off the net. Really nice touch shot over the Furbringer block. Short roll shot by Brad Keenan. Nice patient side out. Keenan taking a rip at it. Just missing. Those are the little things that they've got to do a little bit better. Keenan and Mayer scoring two in a row off floaters to Nick, and they go back and change a serve and then miss a serve.
Yeah. And we're going to go after Brad Keenan, the push out to Keenan. Keenan cut it, pick up by Lucina, just out of reach. Nice dig by Lucina, but just couldn't keep it close to Furbringer.
Got
to
use his left hand on that. Keenan Lucina used to play together 2009, spent a season together on the domestic tour here and abroad. Know each other very well.
And here's Furbringer blocked by Brad Keenan.
Keenan doing a great job, and as long as they're getting his hands over the net, he's creating some tough angles. On our replay, we can see the penetration by Keenan here. Definitely right elbow over the net, penetrating, shoving it straight down for the point. Another float serve to Nick. He takes a full rip. John Mayer with the dig, keeps it in play. Another rip from Lucina. Maybe a frustrated swing. Goes into the bottom of the net. 6-2, Keenan Mayer. This is the point in the game where they just need to be patient and keep doing what's working. Keep serving the ball to Nick Lucina. Right now it doesn't have to be, oh, and there they go. They serve the ball to Matt Furbringer.
And Furby. And it looks like Brad Keenan catching the net. And you were just saying before, keep it on Lucina, keep it on Lucina. A serving error by
essentially a serving error. I mean, especially if you're not going to be jump serving it, with some pace. He's just standing there and giving it to someone. He, they score 4 points on Nick Lucina, and then they take it off him. These are little things that they've just got to do better to close out the three games.
That shot picked up by Mayer. Mayer dug by Lucina. Mayer is there. Keenan on two, and Keenan buries it.
John Mayer getting all sorts of digs now behind the huge Keenan block, who has got his head up on the ball a little bit more, pressing way over the net, allowing John to run down any shot that's steered around him.
All right, I'm trying to see the ball.
As we take a look at Brad Keenan stepping back with a 7-3 lead here in game number two.
You gotta let that guy know.
I've gotta follow that ball.
Furby serving John Mayer on the ocean side, takes a swing, gets blocked cross court. But the play before that, another mistake. Brad Keenan goes back to serve and serves Matt Furbringer. They scored 4 points out of five on Nick Lucena, and now they haven't got him the ball again. Four out of five, then you don't let him touch it for three more tries. These guys might need a coach in the box. Give him some more info. Serve goes to Mayer again. He takes it out wide and goes high line off the top of Matt Furbringer's hands. High line shot. Side out, Keenan, Mayer.
And as we take a look at Johnny Mayer stepping back to serve, a lefty. National champion out of Pepperdine. And there he goes, working Lucina. The set out to Lucina, a little tight, and Keenan swallows it up.
And there it is again. Five out of six plays they've gone to Nick Lucina, and they have scored. 9-5.
9-5 is our score, Keenan and Mayer.
On the replay now, we get a look. Another tight set by Matt Furbringer. No chance for Nick Lucina to penetrate the huge block of Brad Keenan. Sounds very simple, but they've got to just keep the ball right now on Nick Lucina until he can show that he can side out at a higher rate.
And there's Lucina again with the cutty into the net, scored a point.
Make that five out of six. Nick Lucina definitely in a little bit of trouble right now. He's getting the pass he needs. I'm not sure if he's getting the set he needs, or certainly not making the choice that he needs right now. John Mayer back to serve again. 10-5 lead, gives him a floater. High wide set to Nick, who finally bounces one down the line. Looks like there's a little extracurricular activity between Nick and one of the fans.
6-10 on board.
Nick Lucina absolutely punishing the ball down the line on that last play as he steps back to serve 6-10. Nick with the floaty. Going after Brad Keenan. Mayer on two with the pokey, picked up by Lucina. Lucina with a chance to score. Dug again by Mayer. The set out to Mayer. Mayer up and Mayer. Dug again by Lucina. Set out to Lucina. Here he goes. Picked up by Mayer. An outstanding rally. Pushed out to Mayer. Mayer up and Mayer scores cross court.
Our rally of the match so far. Several great, great digs by Mayer and Lucina. Full swings, high lines. Everything was live in that play. You see Mayer scooping up the high line, getting in there on a perfect transition set and taking a full wrap cross court. We get a timeout by Matt Furbringer, slowing it down here at 6-11. Very high level of play going on right now. We've had a full turn of events. 21-14 was the score in the first with Matt Furbringer dominating at the net. Flipped around here. Keenan Mayer have woken up, figured out a nice philosophy to get Nick to center the ball and block line. Now they lead here 11-6. Keenan back to serve from the south side. Back to Nick Lucena again. Same tight set out there. He gets roofed off Matt Furbringer's head. Keenan is feeling it now. This should start to get interesting. Nick Lucen is a very mercurial player, and he goes through these lulls, and then he'll come back right when you least expect it and take over a match. So we'll see what happens here. Interesting choice. They serve it the other way. They go to Matt Furbringer. He goes high hands off the top for an easy side out. I know I'm saying it over and over, but man, is that just you just got to stay on Nick Lucen. I think he's given up 7 points out of 8 serves.
Yeah, you show me, but I'll do it.
And then you switch it up with a float serve and go to Matt Furbringer.
And it's not like some of those serves weren't jump serves. They weren't pushing it. They were actually just floating it over, and it's drifting over to Furby's side.
Yeah, they got to be kicking themselves when that happens, if that's just an error by hand. John Mayer coming in really strong off the good side. Handset taking a rip off Furby in the seam. Side out 13-7.
John Mayer, a national champion out of Pepperdine University. And he'll step back to serve the jump floaty. Goes after Lucena with a nice crisp pass. The set by Furby. Lucena.
Long.
Shot sails long.
By my count, we've got 8 out of 9 to Nick Lucena.
You're their coach and you're in the box. Is that what you're telling Lucena right now? Calm down, choose your shots, settle down a little bit.
Yeah, definitely trying to get his heart rate down. You know, they're warriors out there. They're battling. It's one-on-one basically every time he gets the ball. So just trying to get his heart rate down, let him breathe a little bit, and think about what's going to get them back in the game.
There's a short floaty to Lucena. Passes nicely. Set to Lucena. Lucena scores cross court.
Really nice. Smart swing by Nick there. He took a little pace off, went with about an 80% snap into the court. That's what he's going to need to do to kind of balance his rhythm back out here. Avoid Brad Keenan, make John Mayer do the work in the backcourt.
8 serving 14, Lucena. The jump floaty short to Keenan. Pass nicely. Pushed out to Keenan. Big rip off the block. And Keenan will score 15-8.
Now, one other thing that Nick and Matt should be thinking about or feeling, if not talking about, between some of these points is that they can score. They showed that they can score a ton of points on Keenan Mayer, so they're never out of it.
There's a big rip cross court dug nicely by Mayer. Here's the set, Mayer. And the set drifts over and Furby taps it down. Mayer looking for an over.
That call is never made. I don't care if it is over by half an inch. They're never going to call it. If the defensive player just taps down the overset, they're going to get it.
Here we go.
Kind of a big mistake by Brad Keenan there. Just keep the ball off the net. Chip it around Matt's block. Make Nick have to keep doing work right now. Make him side out every ball. Make him dig and convert every ball for their points.
Furbringer. Floaty down the line to Mayer. Mayer up and Mayer picked up. Set out to Lucena. Lucena scores down the line. Nice solid play.
Another tight set there by Brad Keenan. He sets it tight. Matt Furbringer is going to touch it. And he got soft blocked, put up Nick on two, and a very smart, controlled swing again by Nick Lucena. Timeout must have been very effective for them. He's definitely cooled down and started making some good decisions.
Come on.
Lucena picks it up and drifts over. Mayer to set Keenan. Keenan up. Keenan picked up by Lucena again. Lucena with a chance to score a real one. Can he do it? And he cut shot, finds the net.
That's okay, though. I really like what Nick's doing. He's definitely come out of that timeout, settled down. He's making some great digs, and he's trying to move the ball around a little bit. Here we see his full layout. Unfortunately, went over the net, but he's going to get another dig here. He holds, hides behind the block, releases for that cutting, makes a great defensive play. Keenan Mayer serving Furby right now. And once again, Matt Furbringer sides out first ball. Even though Nick's made some nice choices in his last couple of swings here, they've got to stay on him. They've scored at least 7 or 8 points on him this set alone. And they've got to serve him the rest of the way. Keenan gets served into the middle where they like him. Furby does the angle block once more out of the center of the court, covered by John Mayer. And a throw call. I didn't see anything really wrong with that set. John Mayer got a nice dig. John Mayer reaching over his shoulder, getting a soft dig right into the center of the court. Brad squared up. Easy release. Ball only rotates about a half a rotation. Questionable call there. But as usual, they argue the call, they try and make their point, and just let the referee know they didn't agree with it, and hopefully they move on right here. 4-point game now, just 16-12. Keenan served into the middle, lost focus, sprays the pass, but makes a great recovery off a fantastic transition set by John Mayer. Brad goes high, deep rip down the line for a side out, 17-12. Check that, not John Mayer, but Brad Keenan back to serve. He's gonna go with a controlled jump float to try and get the ball to Nick again. Nice choice, good push pass by Nick. Gets the set he likes, goes high line. Mayer with the pickup on the offside. Full wrap at no block. Matt Ferber makes the dig. Oh, broken set by Nick Lucena. Almost, tough rundown by Nick there. Another point for Keenan Mayer on Nick Lucena, 18-12 now. Probably be best served just to give another floater. Stick with what's working. Nice pass by Nick. Takes a look, delivers a great cut shot.
13-18 is our score here in game number one. If you're just joining us, Lucena Furbringer winning game number one. Sorry, I said number one before, but game number one, 21-14, rather decisively. And now Keenan and Mayer have sort of turned the tables on them, 18-13. And Furbringer gonna throw the floaty into the middle of the net, and that doesn't help anyone.
19 looking at 13. 18-13. Nick and Matt right now basically just want to side out the next couple balls and have something positive to hang on to as they go into this next game. Keenan, John Mayer lets him off the hook with another simple floater finding the middle of the net. Got the mic down on the court. Brad Keenan having a conversation with our up referee. Looks like more than anything, he's joking around, wiping the glasses, trying to get a breather.
Big Wave Dave, the veteran official. Beach volleyball, been doing it for such a long time, does a great job. There's a shot down the line by Johnny Mayer, landing in for the point.
And ladies and gentlemen, we have game points for Keenan and Mayer.
Brad back in jump serving posture, thinks better of it, goes with a floater to Nick again. Shank pass into the net, pulls out a strange high line shot into the corner, all four players laughing about it. Good to see that Nick and Matt, although losing by 5 points and most likely going to lose this set, are still a little loose.
I just missed.
Probably getting more focused on what they're going to do to start the third set, third and final set to 15 points here in Huntington Beach. And set point here now for John Mayer and Brad Keaton on the north side, closest to the pier. And Nick just gives it away, serves it out, ends that set, and is going to move on. Thanks a lot, Tina. Sounds like a good one. You got six footers out there, all 4 6-footers on that women's match. As we come back into the stadium court, more fans still filling in. John Mayer back to serve from the south side. Comes out just like last game. Jump floater to Nick Lucena. Gets a tight set that Brad Keenan can push. Soft block covered by Nick. Another wrap cross court, joust at the net, Furby wins it.
Again, Johnny Mayer playing outstanding defense in this match, both him and Lucena, but Mayer with some absolutely fantastic, controlled digs in this match so far. Again, Nick Lucena trying to get off the court for the Florida State game. Can he do it quickly? Serving after Brad Keenan. Pushed out to Keenan, Keenan up, and Keenan buries it cross court.
Really nice controlled side out there by Brad Keenan. They've been trying to draw him into the middle of the court all day, and it worked a little bit in game one, but not so much last game. He's able to hit real sharp, sideline to sideline, out of the center of the court like that. He comes back into jump float posture, gives another one to Nick. Great pass. Set is close again, ripped and blocked. Almost covered by Matt Furbringer. Nick can't quite run it down. Nick's definitely engaged in this game. He is ready to move on. Get a nice look here. Great set by Matt Furbringer, but a huge move by Keenan over the net. After game one, he something happened to Brad Keenan because he decided I'm going to get over the net. I'm going to penetrate across the net right now. Forget left and right. I'm just going to go get the ball.
And there's an outstanding dig by Johnny Mayer, picked up by Lucina. Lucina to tie it 2-all. And he does cross court. Lucina getting fired up out there, dropping a big hammer cross court. And you said it before, Jeff, Nick Lucina, once he gets a little fire in his belly out there, tends to step up, especially in game threes in this big, tight situation.
Yeah, much like the old Tim Hovland, you know. He can be mad for a while, and it may distract him for a short bit, but that fire usually turns back around if he's got time in the game. And I think you're seeing it right now from Nick.
Furby working on the big guy. Set, and Keenan shot. Sails just out. We'll switch sides.
Good effort by Brad Keenan there, just barely missing the back line, and most likely micro missing the block hit as well of Matt Furbringer. Here he is in the center of court again. Matt takes ball, and Brad just tries to go high hands, missing it by no more than 1 inch. Furby and Nick feeling it, bobbing their heads to the Run DMC going on in the background here, provided by Jeremy Roche. Float serve to Keenan, lays him down on the sideline. Broken set, nobody up. Unbelievable.
Oh my gosh.
Wow. Incredible. Off the net, no look. Rope down the line by Brad Keenan. Froze both the defenders. Side out, Keenan Mayer 3-3. Looks like line blocks provided by Brad Keenan up at the net. Touches it again. Soft block, goes to Mayer. He has to roll it in, cross court to Matt Furbringer. Tight set, Furby goes big, gets stuffed, covered. Brad Keenan on the right. And they call a throw on John Mayer. Another very questionable set. Dave, calling him tight today. Calling him really tight. Calling a double hit on that play, double contact on the set. Common to hear, did the ball spin? Did the ball spin? Is that why it's a double? I'm not seeing a lot of spin on these sets, but spin is not the only thing that causes a double. It just has to hit your hands at separate times to be called a double. Big point going the other way.
Here is Nick Lucina with a jump floaty, working on Keenan. The set out to Keenan. Keenan, short shot picked up by Lucina. Lucina with a chance to score. Dug by Mayer, out of reach.
Not a good sign here for Keenan Mayer. They get a throw call, and then they go ahead and put the hands away and bump set the next ball. Definitely not the set that Brad Keenan was looking for. John pulled him about 8 feet off the net, and he had to just roll a simple little angle shot right into Nick's lap. Nick back to serve, 5'3", staying on Keenan with the jump set, serve.
And another dig by Lucina, pushed by Mayer, the set. Mayer picked up off. Nice pickup to Lucina. Lucina!
And a nice hug by Furby and Lucina. They needed that one. We're getting some great rallies out here. The blockers are doing a fantastic job. Matt Furbringer there hanging, waiting, just getting a little touch on it, and then throwing up a beautiful transition set to Nick with no blocker up. Ba-boom. Hammer time for 6-3. Feeling it.
Going after Brad Keenan. The set out to Keenan on the inside. Keenan ripping it, and Lucina was there.
John Mayer definitely going with the conservative bump setting now. He got called on one play, and he's put away his sweet hand setting. Not really the set that's going to help Brad's vision. He gets pulled off the net like that. But Brad making a nice high swing for a side out. Switching back to the south side. 4-6.
And here is Brad Keenan. Pepperdine, a national champion and player of the year. Setting out cross court, and Lucina shot off the hands of Keenan.
Micro touch. That ball's about 8 feet out, but it probably just caught a hair on the knuckle of Brad Keenan right there. Nick definitely refocused in this third set, very fired up, making some great defensive plays and very much more calm, intelligent, visual decisions up at the net. His team leading 7-4. Matt Furbringer back to serve, still picking on Keenan with the floater down the sideline. Keenan, another soft, easy roll shot into the angle. Nick picks it up easily, but gets stuffed. Keenan saves himself. You gotta love it when a guy's about to give up a side out and he says, nope, I'm gonna stuff you back and save my side out. Great look here at Keenan penetrating the net again. Both hands well over the net. And no cover by Matt Furbringer.
Nick Lucena definitely going for the money ball. Big swing off the hands of Keenan. Almost squeaked it through. Here is Johnny Mayer floating down the middle. Tough pass by Furbringer. The set out to Furby. Furby, oh, just solid in this match. Matt Furbringer.
Furby's playing great right now. He got a medium pass. Nick definitely bettered the ball for him. And Furby up there just first ball sighting out every time. First ball kill, first ball kill.
See if Lucena goes back after Mayer. Goes short to Keenan. And Mayer on two. Blocked by Furbringer. And Matt Furbringer, need I say, coach, is on a roll.
Yeah, both blockers are doing a much better job as the match goes on of touching a lot of different balls. We're going to get a nice look here at Matt penetrating the net. I really don't like to see Brad Keenan standing straight up. Didn't come in and help his partner. Didn't make a call. Didn't cover. But comes back with a great side out. Unfortunately, this game's only to 15 points for them, and you know, you give one and you get one. It's basically a wash. 6-9, they're gonna have to step it up here a little bit. I don't think Nick's gonna be giving away any more easy points the way he did in game two. That's why they tested Matt Furbringer last play, but he's on fire too. So now they're probably back to square one. Who do we serve and how tough? They test Matt Furbringer out again on the sideline. He gets a great handset. Keenan stuffs him back off his head. Mayer the cover on their own side. Chicken wing by Lucena can't quite come up. These blockers are really putting on a show right now. I mean, we could replay almost every one of these blocking plays. We get a view from the back of Keenan surrounding the ball off of Matt Furbringer's head, covered by Mayer. Definitely ready to take the point back and bring it to within two, 7-9.
Keenan going after Furbringer. Lucena pushed out the Furbringer. Furby up. Furby rips it cross court. That ball dug out of reach.
Big rip by Furbringer. Nice answer by him. Just basically bringing the gas. He knew Mayer was there and he said, I'm just going to swing through you, buddy. Every one of these points are huge right now. 10-7. One team needs 8, one team needs 5. So every one of these is huge, hugely important. Can't give away any easy ones right now, especially for Keenan and Mayer. They've got to keep this within 2 points.
Set out to Keenan. Keenan blocked by Furbringer. Set out to Mayer. And Mayer with a great shot called on the line. Splitting the two defenders. Great shot by Johnny Mayer.
Yeah, I certainly hope we don't see anybody not cover anymore, because there's been about 5, 6, 7 phenomenal covers that have saved the point in the last 15 minutes here. One of the most important parts of the game. Cover your hitter.
Lucena pushed out to Furby. Furby, solid down the line, on the line. And as we said all day, Matt Furbringer, solid.
First ball kills. He gets served, he passes, set, kill. His hitting percentage has got to be off the charts right now. And Brad Keenan basically needs to step over and seal all of the line, because a huge portion of these kills are coming down the line.
And Mayer again scores off the hands of Furbringer as they switch sides.
Keenan and Mayer definitely still in the game here. As long as it stays within two, they've got a couple more tries here to pounce and get it tied up.
And of course, both of these teams are undefeated so far today. The winner will advance to the Final Four. The loser falls back in the contenders bracket in this double elimination tournament. And Nick Lucena hit it out.
He missed that one a lot. That's a nice serve. They went back to the floater deep and wide on Nick and got him to spray the ball and not see the court so well. Back to 1 point here. As Matt just said, huge, huge advantage in winning this game and going automatically to the Final Four, getting basically a bye tomorrow morning, where you get to rest, and this losing team's gonna have to play an early one at 8 o'clock.
Nick Lucena with his version of the Todd Rogers. Nice little shot around the block.
Little Raji slap down the line.
12-10.
12-10 on board.
Weather right now is absolutely beautiful. The wind, the 5 mile an hour wind's down to about 1 mile an hour now. It's just a still beautiful low sun setting afternoon here in Huntington Beach. Nick gives the calls, asks Matt, please block line and line, either guy.
And Furby chooses to go after Keenan. Set out to Keenan. Keenan rips it off the hands high and hard. off the hands of Matty Furbringer.
Keenan Mayer fans gotta love that. That's Brad being really tough in the clutch. Huge side out right there, and he went as aggressive as he could off the top of Matt. Johnny Mayer, back jump serve, takes his rip, let's serve ace. That's a tough one. Neither Furby or Lucina could do much on that. It hit the tape and just trickled over right in the dead center short of the court. Tie ball game.
A testament to Johnny Mayer staying aggressive, going for the jumper. Anything can happen. And let's see if he goes for it again. Johnny Mayer flying high, ripping it. Going in, and he served down the line!
Huge rip down the line. He attacked up the middle with a huge jump serve and then turned it really fast down the line. Probably the first point that Matt Furbringer's given up in half an hour. We're going to get a nice look at a replay. Facing John Mayer here from the north to the south. He perfect toss on his shoulder. Big rip turn down the line on Matt. Basically nothing you can do on that. Keenan gives the blocking signs. Line and line, standing in the center of the court. Another rip by Mayer. This time to Nick Lucena on the outside. High set, takes a rip cross court, only shanked by John Mayer.
Johnny Mayer just an inch away from a spectacular dig. That one's sailing just a bit out. And 13 all here in game three, and we have an absolute battle on a beautiful afternoon in Huntington Beach.
Barnburner here, two of the best up and coming defenders for our future overseas and Olympic contention with two of the best blockers.
Lucena going after Mayer. Mayer with a chance to score, and he does. A beautiful controlled shot over the block.
That's a really nice choice by John. He wanted to take Matt out of the play. Just lobbed down a great, quick, flat line shot, bringing them to match point, 14-13. Huge barn burner out here. Uh-oh, Matt shanks it well off the court. Furby on the run, puts it up. Matt quick. Keenan with the dig down the line. Big swing against Nick Lucena, and he gets it. 15-13, Brad Keenan and John Mayer take down Furbringer and Lucena after losing game one, 21-14. They respond with a 21-15 beatdown in game two and a really, really high level, well-played match and game three by all four players.
And what a fantastic comeback by Keenan and Mayer. Just an absolute roller coaster of a match for both teams. We take a look at the replay. Going after a tough shank pass. Nice deep float serve by Mayer Keenan. And here is Brad Keenan with his chance to take this game and go to a Final Four. And he brings the heat around Nick Lucena. And what a great match here on Stadium Court. It looks like we're going to have Adrian Karambula and Steve Gratowski coming up next. Steve Gratowski playing on the Olympic team for London. An absolutely a fun and exciting team to watch. Adrian, the skyballer, one of the toughest skyballs, I would say, in the world, absolutely.
In the world, absolutely.
And they're going to face off against Hayden and Scott in a rare elimination match. And that's coming up live on Jose Cuervo Pro Beach Volleyball Series.com. And it's been a great day, ladies and gentlemen. We appreciate you all coming out and watching. And, of course, if you're close to us in the Huntington Beach area, what a great place to come down, hang out with us, as Jeff was saying before. The weather's been absolutely fantastic. There's tons of stuff to do here. We have the mechanical line bowl. You can climb the rock wall. There's so many fun things to do. But, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back in just a few minutes. It's the Jose Cuervo National Championships Huntington Beach Open.
Stay tuned.